This is something I've been wanting to do for some time. I've been having some fairly problematic times with the Zenith carburetor currently fitted. A few weeks ago, well, a few months ago, during the hotter weather, the thing was really spluttering in traffic, and I think what had happened was the Zenith carburetor had got too hot, warped, and started leaking. So I took it off that night, as the thing was really running like a bag of bolts, and stripped and rebuilt it. Obviously I couldn't spend so much time flatting it off like I would like to. What tends to happen with the Zenith, because of its design, it warps and then starts to leak in all sorts of places. So just replaced the seals that I could and cleaned the jets and so on, and it's been okay. Struggling to start because it seems to suck so much fuel on starting, it almost floods itself. Then running, it's fine. Hot starting, forget it, it won't have it. It just, you crank it and crank it and crank it, and it seems to be the hot spot in the manifold that's causing the issue. So this SU conversion should actually do away with those problems. The SU is a much better instrument in the first place. It's a slightly bigger bore, I think, so it's obviously you're increasing the gas flow through the engine. Yeah, it's probably going to be a bit more juicy, but I should think a lot more fun to drive. We've got a new inlet manifold to suit it. This has a little water passage through it to stop carburetor icing in winter. Obviously that's for the vacuum pipe of the servo, if you've got one. I've got a new exhaust manifold. You don't have to have this, but I didn't fancy getting the studs out of the original to put this plate on. So there's a blanking plate for the hot spot. So we'll do away with a lot of the problems that that causes with modern fuel. And I've also spent a bit of time, if we can just turn it around, porting it, because the casting was a bit rough, quite restrictive. So I've just made it, smoothed off all the edges and made the ports a slightly larger bore. They were smaller than the head, if I remember rightly. So that wouldn't have been helping anything. Now the issue is very different to the Zenith in that the choke, for example, actually moves the jet rather than anything inside. Obviously you've got a throttle butterfly in the same sense, but you have this damper inside a dash pot here full of oil, and this just, if I can move it, which I can't, this just moves up and down what with demand and adjusts the jet, the needle. So it's constantly regulating. So I think it's a much better bit of kit and not so prone to warping as the old Zenith. So other parts of this kit, we've got a new air filter. There's a little throttle linkage somewhere that has to go on. Various bits I've put together, not including in the kit. You'll need all the manifold bolts and so on and so forth. I've got water pipe for the heating passage in the carburetor, and a free flow back box that is included in the kit. So instead of the usual baffles, you can see straight through the back box. It's just got an absorption type back box on it. Then we've got a front section, which will be really fun to fit, and a middle section. So that's kind of it. I'm going to get on with it, and it's not going to be a step by step by any means. I'll just show you any problems I come across, any points of interest, and more importantly, how the thing runs. This is a quick look at the standard setup with the oil bath air filter, a long intake hose, and the Zenith 36 IV carburetor. You can see what I mean about the hot spot on the manifold, where it's actually bolted direct to the exhaust manifold. So first thing to do is just, I think we're going to loosen all the manifold bolts, make sure they're going to come out, and then I can unbolt the exhaust. Obviously we can then disconnect all these fittings, saving this one for the new manifold. Quite a bit to do. So the manifold came away fairly painlessly, but you'll notice there's a few splits in the gasket. notice the oil. Obviously, it does use a little bit of oil. I think I put about half a pint of oil in a week, which is a lot less than I used to, but I don't know what's typical of these engines. But perhaps at some point, it'll be time for a cylinder head rebuild. Anyway, we'll give it a bit of a clean up and see how the new manifold lines up. The other thing I've done is just to release the exhaust at the other end. So that's basically ready to drop out when the time comes, and it gives a bit more clearance for the new manifold. So I've cleaned up the gasket mating face now, which is in quite good condition really. Just got the vacuum cleaner vacuumed out, make sure there's no muck in there. Same for the threads as well. Cleaned up all the bolts, which most of which I shall reuse because they're in perfect condition, thread wise anyway. And you'll note that on this particular cylinder head, HRC 1301, this is an 8-to-1 compression, but it has metric threads. In other parts of the engine you'll find imperial threads. Just one of the idiosyncrasies of the later Land Rover engines. The instruction book with the kit suggests that you fit the inlet manifold first, so that's what I'm going to do. So I've actually installed the exhaust manifold first, reason being that having looked at it I couldn't see how I was going to fit the exhaust manifold once the intake was fitted, so I decided to ignore that bit of the instructions. I can see why it says that, to do with clearance between the manifold and the new inlet manifold. But with the engine in the vehicle, you can't really do it that way round. So first I thought, there's no way the carburetor will go on there, and it won't with that bracket in place. So it is actually necessary to remove these two bolts, as it does say in the instructions, and remove this bracket. But I'm fitting the new shortened linkage, this bit, with it bolted in place, mainly because it's fixed to something, it's easier to work on. But what I have had to do is just put a little twist on the end of the return spring, because it had a habit of wanting to jump out. So hopefully that will stop it. Having had that once before and the throttle jamming open, don't want it happening again. The carburetor bolted on, obviously the throttle bracket still removed. You can see I've put the vacuum fitting in, and note the spacer here between carburetor and manifold. I believe that's to stop the transfer of heat. There's the vacuum connection for the distributor, the advance, fuel inlet, throttle, choke. And we need to remember to fill up the dashboard with oil. So this is where we finished today. Just went out of time really. We're getting dark soon. So obviously there's a number of things that I need to sort properly. Choke cable wasn't long enough, so pinched a little bit off my got an old bicycle with a Sturmey Archer hub, and I nicked a bit off that. Obviously it's a complete bodge, I must stress that. Not the sort of thing I'd normally leave like that, but it works, and we'll get it on the road. Similarly, see these cable ties here, just holding the throttle mechanism on. I had to bend this rod, had to shorten that one. It was quite a performance, but I'll take you through some of what I did in the next video. I think the oil in the dashboard might be a bit heavy. Gonna have to do something about that, or increase the spring pressure. Anyway, that's quite sweet. That is how a 2.25 should run. How sweet is that? texture again, as if it's slightly smoky at idle. That's the first thing that's noticeable, is how much cleaner it's sticking over. I can actually sit behind it without choking. So that should be better come MOT time. I'm quite sure how it was getting through before actually. So, as I say, obviously there's a few things to sort out, like the breather here for example. So I'm just going to put a bit of pipe on that and run it away from the exhaust so it doesn't drip any oil. I'll put a little catch can in there for that. But it's running so sweetly now. So, I think I'm going to take it for a drive soon. Last thing to do is just put the air filter on. If you're setting up without test equipment, what you need to do is lift this quarter inch. So that's just slightly too rich, because as you probably heard, the engine speed increased. So we lift this, sorry, a 1/16 of an inch. I think I said quarter inch. Lift this 1/16 of an inch. There should be very little change. Another half turn. So that's pretty much spot on, I think. Got to tappy tap it. Very happy. Well, that seems to have been something of a success. Obviously, as I said, it's far from finished yet. There's a few bits to tidy up. The heating pipe work for the carburetor manifold and the exhaust has got to be done. I've got a couple of days off late next week before starting a new job on Monday. So hopefully have an afternoon to get those bits all tidied up. I think the only thing that was really difficult was the throttle mechanism. That really took some setting up, took a lot of thought and tinkering about with until I got it right. It really doesn't stress quite well enough in the manual some of the changes you need to make, like actually removing the throttle linkage from its bracket, and the picture in the manual supplied is very poor. You really can't tell what's going on. I think for what the kit cost, I would expect, you know, a full colour instruction manual with it. But otherwise, I'm quite impressed. The performance gain is incredible. The issue makes it far more tractable. There's no flat spots. You plant your foot and the thing just goes. There's a bit of road where I'd never normally get past 50, where you can do 60 legally. Planted my foot going up there and approached 60 very quickly, and I reckon it would probably now do 80 if I kept my foot planted. Not I really need to do that. Definitely an improvement not having the hot spot on the manifold. It's going to need the heating line plumbed in, because you could see condensation on the outside, so in cold weather that is going to be an issue. So I shall get on and do that next week. But otherwise, I'm very impressed. As I say, the only difficult bit was the throttle mechanism. There's a few bits you have to cut and alter positions of. It could do with some better diagrams and pictures supplied to help with that. The choke cable wasn't long enough, so I'm going to have to do something about that. Petrol pipe hooked straight up. I had to change the vacuum line, but yeah, otherwise it wasn't too problematic really. Anyway, so I hope you've enjoyed the video, and I'll update you again when the improvements are finally finished.